You are certainly the air we breathe, Lord. Hallelujah, we love you, Jesus. At home with me as I say a quick prayer. Hallelujah. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for this time that we can be together, Lord God. Even if it's not in the natural, but in the spirit, we are together, Lord God. Lord God, you are here. The Holy Spirit is here. Wherever you're watching, the Holy Spirit is there and he's with you. Good morning, church. So I'd like to share a moment or two, not very long, about what God put on my heart regarding some of the events that happened last Wednesday. And it was a difficult time. I'm not going to sugarcoat that. It was a difficult time. But I asked the Lord, I said, Lord, what do you want me to learn from this. And I kind of felt an impression of God saying to me this scripture. And this is what I based the rest of what I'm going to speak on today. It's in Proverbs 3:5. I'm going to read a bunch of scriptures, but they're all quick. Proverbs 3:5 says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding, but acknowledge me in all of your ways, and I will make your paths straight." Well, after I read that and the Lord impressed it upon me, I said, wow, you know, and this is what basically I felt to share on. I looked at the Capitol building, and I want to just say a few things regarding that before I speak. This isn't a political thing, what I'm speaking about at all. In fact, it's the furthest thing from it right now. Speaking politically is a totally different subject. It's not for now. And that's not necessarily, you know, here at the pulpit. But I just want to share, because it is entwined in what I'm saying. You know, growing up as a kid, the Capitol building, the White House, Capitol, the monuments, you know, were revered, and I looked at them in awe, and they were protected. Then 9/11 hit, and, you know, places I worked at, and it's the World Trade Center, you know, for certain jobs I did, that was gone. And then when I looked at what happened this last Wednesday to our Capitol, and regardless of what the underlying causes are, and regardless of what happened, why it happened, who did it, you know, that's not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is the idea of temporal things on this earth that we look at that are so rock solid in our spirit when it comes to what we are used to. And, you know, things like we saw with the World Trade Center when they were taken down and the thousands of lives that were lost, and, you know, and things of that nature, iconic things that our country are built on. And growing up, you know, having, you know, a real idea that, hey, that's a symbol for our country. You know, that's a symbol for our country. The Capitol building, for over 200 years of our laws and our decisions that guided our country and where we are today were taking place in that building. So it was a little heartbreaking for me to watch it. You know, so I was a little bit disappointed, and I was a little bit taken aback when I first saw it, because I was working. I didn't see it when it happened. I went home and I watched it. And when I was looking at it, I felt the Spirit of the Lord share to me about what trust really means and how trust is important for us to have in certain areas of our lives, but it's the most utmost important for us to have trust in the Lord. And that's what my message is today. The title of my message, and it's simple, and it's spelled out: trust God, period. Not the dot. Trust God, period. You know, for years ago, I remember God said it. I read it. God said it. I believe it. That settles it. That was a big phrase back in the 90s and the 80s in Christianity. God said it. I believe it. That settles it. Well, kind of like what I'm saying now. Trust God, period. Because all these things we look at, all of these institutions that were created by man, they're temporal. They will rise and they will fall. And the Lord says, trust me, because I will never leave you nor forsake you. We read that last week. Last week I shared on the idea of, you know, what it's like to have a troubled soul, hope for a troubled soul. Well, that was before this happened. And when I shared about that, I felt that there was a shaking going on with the virus. You know, especially we talked about the virus and how the virus is really causing so much, you know, trouble in our society and around the world, and how the enemy is utilizing that to destroy lives and destroy finances. Well, let me tell you, the enemy is even more so utilizing this terrible thing that happened. in so many negative ways. It's putting so many pressure. It's caused probably half of America to be a little bit despondent. But that brings me to this point. Anytime you put your trust in mankind, or human nature, you will be let down, disappointed, disillusioned, and left bitter. Let me just talk a little bit about that. And I'm going to talk about the things that happen when we do that. There's been many times I've trusted people in my life and they've let me down. That's more of a common occurrence. However, when it comes to something like this, where we're hanging on a thread of maybe words or actions of people in positions that are in authority in this land, be very wary of how we trust people, especially in government. And that's not a negative thing to say about government. It is just a real thing to say about government. And what I mean by that is that we're all human beings. We all are fallible. We all have fallen short of the glory of God. And I'm not here on my soapbox saying, you know, oh, I wouldn't have done those things. Let me tell you, when there's pressure on people, when there are pressure on people to do things that affect millions of people, you don't know what you would do. I don't know what I would do. I would hope and pray I would know what to do. But the reality is that I think it was like a sharpening of my spirit towards, you know, what we see is like, oh, that'll never happen, or this will never happen. All bets are off right now. And I believe that's why God's pointing us back to him. He's pointing us back to him, saying, trust me. Stop putting your eggs in one basket, all your apples in one apple cart. Trust me. The Lord says, trust me. We are going to read a bunch of scriptures this morning regarding that. But this is what I wrote I wrote down after what I said. We have to have a level of understanding about what I just said. I'm going to read it again. I'm saying this. Anytime you put your trust in man, which is mankind, human nature, you will be let down, disappointed, disillusioned, and left bitter. Now, that is not what I'm talking about. Like, for instance, like, we trust that when we're a child, our parents are going to love us and take care of us. That's not what I'm talking about. We trust when we wake up in the morning that the sky is going to be blue. We trust those things. Those are things that are steadfast in our spirit. We trust that gravity is real. If I drop this, the Bible right now, it's going to fall to the floor. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about putting an overemphasis on trust in things in this world that are temporal. And the scripture that came to my mind this morning was the wise man and the foolish man. The man that built his house, the foolish man built his house on the sand. And when the waves came and tossed to and fro, it destroyed his house, destroyed everything he had. But a wise man puts builds his house upon a rock, the rock of Jesus, amen? And that rock, when these things happen like it's happening now, that rock will not be shaken. That house will stand, amen? So it's the scripture that God gave to me. So I want to just move on because I have a few scriptures to read. I don't want to be long. We're on the internet, so it's a little different than in person. So like I was saying, I feel that if the Lord was speaking to me about this, I would hope maybe some people would feel the same way. But I can only speak about what the Lord's speaking to me. And that is, take your eyes off a little bit of what's happening in the world and put your eyes back on me. Trust me right now for what's happening in this world. Do not look at the circumstances, because the circumstances were caused by fallible men, and I'm a fallible person. So I'm not going to trust in those that have sin in their lives or make error in their lives. Sin is just missing the mark, and we all miss the mark. The point is that I'm going to trust my God, amen? We have to trust our God, because God is the one that's trustworthy. He's the only one that's trustworthy. So I know in the book of Jeremiah, it says this, and I'll paraphrase it. I mean, I could, the human heart is wicked and deceitful above all. Who can know it? And basically what that means is that like we talked about human nature, human beings, we know our frailties. And if nobody can know the human heart, and it has these things in it, and we try to look towards situations where we say, oh, you know, we have this situation with our government, or we have this situation with our military, or we have this situation with leaders that are going to, you know, they're steadfast and they're going to stay attacked, you know, they're going to stay intact on what we believe. That is what we hope and pray for, and that's why we elect officials that we believe will do that. But if anything's told us this, and this isn't about our president or anything like that. I'm not talking about that. This could have been 10 years ago, 20 years ago. It doesn't matter. The message is just brought to my attention now, but it could be spoke years ago. But the idea is the same. If man's heart is wicked and deceitful above all, let's build our house upon a rock so when these things happen, we don't get thrown to or fro. I've talked to some friends. I've talked to some people after this, and there's a shaking, you know, in some people, even people that know the Lord, because this was very, very serious, and it became a very, very difficult thing to watch, and it was, you know, it was a difficult thing, and most people I know were horrified at it, and I was too. I had a friend of mine that went to D.C. She was there with her brother, and they went to the rally, and there was nothing wrong. She's been to rallies before. She said it was fine. But something told her that you should leave now. I don't want to say it's God, because that would be me putting words in her mouth. But she felt to leave. Nothing happened. There was nothing going on. And she's like, we better get out of here. It wasn't like that. She just felt to leave. And I'm saying all that to say this, that if we put our emphasis on trusting the Lord, and it's hard. I'm not going to say it's not hard, because that would be a lie. When I was a young boy, when my dad and I would work on a project, and I was a little more inclined when it came to certain things than my dad, and he admitted it. He would, if we were building something or doing something with the car or anything, I would kind of see what he was doing was maybe not going to work exactly the way he wanted it, just because I was inclined. He was inclined in so many other areas more than I was. But in this one area, I kind of said, Dad, it's not going to work. And he would get so angry at me because he would say, boy, oh boy, I named you the right name. You are a doubting Thomas. I named you the right name. And obviously, my full name is Thomas. So I always think of that. But my father had faith in what he was doing at the moment, and I was always doubting Thomas, and I don't like that about my personality. That's something I fight with every day. I have to fight the negativity sometimes in my own life, and truthfully, you know, right now, the way the Lord is moving, and he's saying, trust me, trust me, trust me, I wrestle with that every day, because this COVID thing, you know, it affected my family a little bit. It affected my, you know, just like your guys' family and just like everybody's family that's going through this. And I had to, you know, kind of make some adjustments. And let me tell you, when brass tacks comes down, in other words, when push comes to shove, the reality is this, we have to trust God. And I struggle with it, but I am trusting God. I'm going to believe in faith right now that I'm going to trust God for every part of my life, my family's lives, for this country. And I will lift up the country before we end. So I just want to read a few scriptures. Again, title of my message, Trust God, period. P-E-R-I-O-D. Trust God, comma, period. You don't have to put a comma, but trust God, period. Amen? So I read the first one already. Scriptures that I looked up and I really feel are apropos. First one, trust in the Lord with all your heart, that's Proverbs 3:5, and do not lean on your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he, God, will make your path straight. What does that mean, path straight? It doesn't mean you're going to have, you know, you're not going to have bumpy roads, but he'll make it straight. In other words, he will be with you to walk through those bumpy roads. Psalm 46, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. If we are still and know that he is God, Our trust is it's a second nature. If we're still and know that he's God, trust follows right along. Amen? I'm going to skip down for time's sake to a different scripture. Bear with me as I get it. I have to write them out a little bit. This is an interesting scripture. I never read this scripture before. It's in Psalm 112, verse 7. He is not afraid of bad news. He, God. His heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. I'm sorry, he is referring to us, and his heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. He, in other words, we, are not afraid of bad news if our heart is firm in what? Trusting in the Lord. We are not afraid of bad news. Our hearts are firm if we trust in the Lord. Amen? That scripture is perfect for, it said a capital H, that's why I thought first he was talking about God. But when I read it originally, I realized he was talking about us, and now I do too. It's like if we really, really get bad news. So this is important. If we get bad news, which is what just happened, and our heart is firm, trusting in the Lord, that bad news will come, and it'll go. Time will take care of it. It'll come. But if our heart is not trusting in the Lord, if the bad news comes and we are not trusting in the Lord, you know what happens? Rocks our world for a while. Who gets the glory when our world is rocked? Our enemy of our soul, the devil. Because when our world is rocked, when we don't trust God, and we just look at the circumstances, the enemy goes, yeah, yeah, look at that news. Look at that. Look at this great government that, you know, is in this country. Ha ha, look at you. You believed in that. Now look. It can be really discouraging if we don't trust the Lord, because the enemy will have a field day with our emotions. The enemy will have a field day with everything we do. And that's why this scripture, which I never read before, it says he is not afraid. In other words, talking about a single person. He is not afraid of bad news. This is a person that trusts in the Lord. His heart is firm, and he trusts in the Lord. Amen? Another one. Isaiah 26:3. You keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts you. Amen. You keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts you. Amen? Tremendous scriptures. Excuse me. Four scripture. Psalm 37, verses 4 through 6. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust in him, and he will act. He will bring forth your righteousness as the light and your justice as the noonday. Amen? These are all promises from our Lord. And if we just trust him, it says right in his word, trust me and I'll do these things. I will act. He will act for us. That's the Lord speaking. I will act. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust in him and he will act. That's Psalm 37:5. That's part of that scripture. This is a great one. Isaiah 41:10. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Boy, oh boy, the more I read these scriptures, the more I realize how much the Lord wants us to trust him. And a key element of trust. You cannot trust God if you don't have faith. Faith and trust work hand in hand. They work hand in hand. They work together. How could you trust something you don't have faith in? God says, have faith in me. I will never leave you nor forsake you. I knew you before you were born. Amen? I know every hair that's on your head. Have faith in God. Trust God. They go hand in hand. One or two more. This is very, very good for what we're going through. Do not be anxious. This is in, I'm sorry, Philippians 4, verse 6 and 7, if you're looking them up at home. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. That's in Philippians. That is so apropos for what we're going through right now. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be known to God. God, I said this last week. I asked a friend if it was inappropriate. He says it's not. I'm going to say it again. All hell is breaking loose around us. Okay? All hell is breaking loose around us. Don't be anxious about it, but in everything by prayer and supplication. In other words, while it's happening, go to God. Say, God, what's going on? What do I do? What do I do? Tell me what to do. With thanksgiving, Lord, I thank you, but you know, we need to know what's going on. Make your request be known to God and be honest with God. God, this is freaking me out. And the peace of God which surpasses all understanding. How many people want to know that peace is imparted unto us? So we can settle our spirit and we can hear the word of the Lord and we can hear God's voice. And the peace of God which surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. I feel to stop here and pray for our country. I want to just say, by no means am I down on our president right now or our government per se, or, you know, I'm not bashing anybody. I'm just, or talking negatively about the administration now. It's really not, like I said, it's not, what happened is what I'm talking about, but not specifically all the reasons and all these other things. I'm not interested in talking about that. So I do want to pray. And in conclusion, I do want to say this. In conclusion, we must be able to trust certain people in our life, our family and our friends, our church leadership, and so on. We have to trust. I mean, we can't just turn around and say, I don't trust anybody. Then we become embittered. I believe it all comes down to our perspective and our faith in God, and that God will do what he says in his word. Trusting God in everything, and God will work all things together for those who love him and are called according to his purpose. Amen. We trust him. We say, God, we don't know what's going on, but you're going to work it all together for good according to your purpose for those that love him and are called according to his purpose. He's going to work it all together for good. Let's bow our heads where we are right now. Lord Jesus, I thank you for... It's an honor to share your word, Lord God, and it's an honor to believe and trust in you, Lord. I pray right now for our nation right now. Lord, you are the one who knows the beginning from the end. Only you knows, you know what's going to happen. But we trust right now in the power of Jesus Christ. You are the ruler of the world, and governments shall rest upon your shoulders, Lord. And you control, Lord God, everything that's happening, even though for us down here we don't see it. We know you're in control of it, Lord God. We trust you this morning, Lord. We trust you right now by the power of your Holy Spirit to come and convict us if we need to change our lives and to let us repent if we need to repent. But also, Lord God, we pray for this nation that convict those that are doing wrong and bring those to your cross, Lord God, that need salvation, Lord. That's what we need mostly, Lord God. We need to know, Lord God, that people are accepting you as their Savior. If we all accept Christ, Lord, and that's what you want for us, Lord God, then we won't have as much trouble in our governments. Lord, I ask you to draw men unto you, Lord God. And as this happens, Lord God, let us, the church, be ready to share the gospel. Lord, we want to be able to share your gospel and be able to move. Let us be bold about the true answer, which is trust in the Lord. I thank you, Lord God, for our governments right now. As messed up as they are, Lord God, we believe you're going to be able to straighten it all out, Lord God, by your wisdom and your beautiful, wonderful, loving hands of mercy. You will be able to guide us back to where we need to be, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, in advance for a good report. And we just thank you, Jesus, in your precious name. this Sunday morning, we pray, amen and amen.